Short prelude D major. Beautiful prelude. This prelude has three voices. Bach's preludes are divided in two voices preludes and three voices preludes. So this one has three voices written in D major, and it has some features of the fugue. It has the theme. Theme would be this little phrase. Then it occurs again in the lower voice. Then middle voice. Again lower voice. So first thing, find the subject and listen how it is moving from one hand to another, from one voice to another voice. There are many 16th notes. In addition to subject, there are some lines of 16th notes. To make it very flowing and even, listen to 16th notes, how they continue from one voice to another. For example, beginning. To listen to the line of 16th notes. That will make pulse more even and it will make it more continuous. There are many long notes here, and to keep this continuous development of the phrasing, it's very important for us to listen to the long notes so we don't interrupt those long notes. For example, in the beginning. Two voices in the left hand, middle voice and bass. We cannot play them just one after another like this. If we play them absolutely the same, it will not be clear that we have two voices. We'll be sounding like one voice. So, to have two voices, we have one voice as leading voice and another voice being softer. I made bass as a leading voice. Now I will do middle voice. This allows me to have two lines in the left hand. The same can be done later in the right hand here. Two different voices could be done as alto, a leading voice, as middle voice would be a leading voice. So this way we can hear the texture. On harpsichord we cannot do such thing because dynamics are the same, though we still can hear those voices differently as we would be singing them, or as it would be a choir texture. In choir texture, it would be soprano, alto, tenor, bass, if we have four voices, and each voice has its own line. Very important to hear this when we play on piano, on any keyboard instrument. On harpsichord we would not be able to do it, but on piano we can do different dynamics and we can show layers of this music because it is polyphonic music. It is helpful to practice each voice alone, like this, bass. Combine them in couples, let's say soprano and bass without middle voice, or middle voice and upper voice without bass. And such practicing allows to hear all the texture, all the voices as we would be conducting the choir. There are no trills in this prelude. Mostly we have developed voicing, so probably most of the work would be this type of work, listening to the layers and building up the texture in three voices. Dynamics are not written, as always in Bach's music, we don't have dynamics, but we can have some dynamics. For example, in measure 8 it could be softer. And measure 10 can be seen as one of the culminations. There are several uncomfortable moments, just in coordination wise, in 15, measure 15, measure 17. In the left hand, we have to hold some notes, at the same time we have to release some notes. So just be very precise. Holding all the notes exactly and releasing them in time, we have beautiful texture, which it sounds like playing with pedal, even if we don't pedal. Especially effective it would be on harpsichord. So all voices are blossoming. I will try to include video of me playing on harpsichord, so just check at the end. If I have it, I will include it at the end. Thank you, and keep practicing.